So hello friends, good evening, how are you? Welcome to the next session of Dermatology on Let's Crack Neat PG YouTube channel. So I hope you all know me, I am Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your Dermatology Educator on an Academy. As well as I will give you the tips and tricks to solve your exams, for example Neat PG, because I have myself scored All India Rank 261. Now before going ahead, I just want to tell you that what is an Academy? It is the best online teaching platform for the preparation of Neat PG. Now, how to download Unacademy? Just install the Unacademy learning app, choose Neat PG. Now, why you have to choose Neat PG batch on Unacademy? Because we are coming up with very good courses on Neat PG on Unacademy. You will have one batch course which is starting on 14th of January. There are many other batch courses which are starting. So we have new batch every year with top educators, seamless uninterrupted learning, and these are some of the batch courses which we are about to start. Next is, every day you have a Neat PG combat, please use my referral code CHESHTA10 to get yourself enrolled into this batch course. And also, if you want to get enrolled, please use my referral code CHESHTA10 for the enrollment. Okay? Now next is, you have two type of subscriptions on Unacademy. One is Plus and second is Iconic. Iconic gives you the access of both Unacademy as well as Prep Ladder. So here you have a 1 month subscription, which is around 55,000 rupees. But if you use my referral code, you will get the same subscription in 49,500. And the next is the Plus subscription, which have the options of 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. So here you can go with a 5,000 rupees subscription fees. But if you use my referral code, you can get the same subscription in 4,500 rupees if you use my referral code. Now, as you all know that Neat PG dates are out. And that is why we have designed a special session today as well as tomorrow. In today's session, I will give you the tips to solve the case-based questions. Now, starting with the first question of the today's lesion, and that is from the hypopigmentary disorder. The question is, a 30-year-old patient presented with many hypopigmented patches on the trunk. Many patients around him also seems to have similar complaint. There is no previous significant family history and the lesions were non-scaly. The Wood's lamp examination is negative. What is the diagnosis? Option is pityriasis versicolor, borderline Hansen's, pityriasis alba or vitiligo. Can anybody tell me what is the answer of this question? Anyone can answer what is the best possible answer? Yes, very nice. Please remember the correct answer here is option number 2, that is borderline Hansen. Now, borderline leprosy patients can present with depigmented anesthetic patches. The question says that there is also presence of similar complaint in the other members of the family or the patients or the members around him. So please remember, Hansen's, it is an infective condition which can spread from one person to another person, and this can occur secondary to the inhalatory route. So in these patients, you can have depigmented patches. Now, Wood's lamp finding will be absolutely negative. There will be no feature on Wood's lamp in the patient of Hansen's disease. But in pityriasis versicolor, you will see a yellow color fluorescence. In vitiligo, you will see an ivory color lesion on Wood's lamp. But it is absolutely negative in the patients of borderline leprosy. So this becomes a classical case of hypopigmented lesions or a borderline Hansen's. Next is, a 5-year-old child presented with faint hypopigmented lesion. There is mild scaling. He also falls sick frequently and has a frequent asthmatic episode. The diagnosis is, so please answer this question, a patient with a history of asthma and a history that he frequently falls sick. What is the correct answer? Post-Kala-Azar dermal leishmaniasis, borderline Hansen's, pityriasis alba or vitiligo. Can you tell me what is the diagnosis of this particular question? Anyone can answer? Very nice. Please remember, if in a children or in a child you see a ill-defined or faint hypopigmented lesion, ill-defined or faint hypopigmented lesion with associated scaling, it is a case of pityriasis alba. And pityriasis alba is associated very frequently with atopic dermatitis. Please remember this point that pityriasis alba is associated with atopic dermatitis. You can see mild scaling as well as you will see the ill-defined patches, which is very, very common. But in patients of borderline Hansen's, in PKDL, you will have associated history of fever. In borderline Hansen, you will have loss of sensation. And in vitiligo, if you do a Wood's lamp examination, you will see an ivory white color. There will be no scaling over the lesions of vitiligo. And that is why this becomes a classical case of pityriasis alba. Going towards the next question, everyone please answer this question for me. Everyone answer this question. A 30-year-old patient with mucocutaneous lesions since 5 years. The lesions have started on the oral mucosa followed by skin lesions. On examination, the skin lesions are raw and painful. So remember my mnemonic, whenever you see a patient with bullae lesion or you see the oral lesion, you have to think about vesiculobullous disorder. So the patient have oral lesion followed by a flaccid bulla with Nikolsky sign positivity. What is the diagnosis? Vulgaris, foliaceous, bullous pemphigoid or cicatricial pemphigoid? Anybody can tell me the answer. Yes, very nice. Please remember the correct answer is pemphigus vulgaris because skin lesion plus mucous lesions along with Nikolsky sign positive is classical of pemphigus. In pemphigus foliaceus, you will have no oral mucosal involvement. You have no oral mucosa involved. And in bullous pemphigoid and cicatricial pemphigoid, you will have negative Nikolsky sign. You have negative Nikolsky sign. So like that, you can differentiate these disorders. I hope this is very easy to all of you for understanding. Moving to the next question. Please answer this question, all of you. A 40-year-old male who presented with itchy blister on his body, he often excoriates it. On examination, the blisters are grouped and many scratch lesions are seen. He refused biopsy, but it responds to the dietary modification and the medication given for this condition. So you have to tell me which among the following will have improvement with the dietary modification as well as those who have itchy blisters. Anyone can answer this question, a very easy question. Very nice. The correct answer here is dermatitis herpetiformis. Please remember, dermatitis herpetiformis will have presence of excoriated lesions which are itchy. Itchy excoriated lesions which are present mainly over the extensor aspect. For example, elbow, knee, buttock and shoulder. Okay? And it will respond to the dietary modification. Why it will respond to dietary modification? Because here you have gluten sensitive enteropathy. So in gluten sensitive enteropathy, they will respond very well to the dietary modification. They are advised to prevent bro, which means they should not eat barley, rye, oat and wheat. They should prevent all these four agents. And the drug of choice here, which is the drug of choice? The answer is Dapsone. Dapsone becomes the drug of choice, which is very, very important for the treatment of the dermatitis herpetiformis. Now, coming to the next question, please answer this question quickly. Everyone, please answer this question quickly. A 4-year-old child who presented with painful eruptions affecting the flexures. The patient was hospitalized and on examination, there was erythema with peeling, blistering of the skin. Few flaccid blisters were present at the margin. The skin of the trunk shows faint erythema. What is the diagnosis? There is no history about the immunofluorescence, but please look at the clinical picture. The clinical picture gives you a lot of hint. If you remember this, the question is very easy. Yes, very nice. So this is a classical case of linear IgA dermatosis, or it is also called as chronic bullous dermatosis of childhood. And what is this classical appearance? It is called as string of pearl appearance, which means that there is a large central bulla and multiple small bullae. So this is a classical case of chronic bullous dermatosis of childhood, and here you have defect of BP180 or BP antigen 2. ठीक है. सो आई होप दिस इज ऑल्सो क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. बीपी एंटीजन 2 और बीपी 180 विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. That the chronic bullous dermatosis of childhood, which present with string of pearl, will have antigen or antibody against BP antigen 2. Everyone, please answer this question. A very important question. Look at the clinical picture. They are telling that the patient is a classical case which presents with around 10 to 20 asymmetrical lesions like this. The lesions are of variable size, the bizarre shape and irregular borders with a zoographic appearance. What is the diagnosis? Tuberculoid leprosy, borderline tuberculoid, BB Hansen's or lepromatous leprosy. This is a very, very classical clinical picture. If you have seen it before, anyone can answer this question. Yes, very nice. Please remember, this is a classical case of borderline leprosy. And what is this picture showing? This is showing inverted saucer shape appearance. Inverted saucer shape appearance or Swiss cheese appearance or punched out appearance. So this is a case of BB Hansen's which presents with inverted saucer shape appearance, Swiss cheese appearance or punched out lesion. Going towards the next question, requesting everyone to please answer this quickly. Very nice. A 15-year-old girl who was brought by her mother with complaints of sudden onset of fever. There is a history of headedness, nausea, vomiting, watery diarrhea. Physical examination reveals a desquamating rash. She has no sick contact and there is no evidence of ingestion of unsafe food. But she gives a history of menstruation a little a month ago. So can you tell me what is the diagnosis? Yes, very nice. The correct answer is toxic shock syndrome. Toxic shock syndrome occurs secondary to the staph infection. Now those females who uses tampons during the menstruation, sometimes they forget to remove these tampons and these tampons will then get accumulated, the blood will get accumulated and will give rise to development of staph. The exfoliative toxin from this staph aureus will release and will cause exfoliation of palmoplantar skin along with headache, nausea, vomiting and watery diarrhea. So please remember, this is a classical case of toxic shock syndrome. So thank you everyone for your patience listening. This was a very short class on the case-based questions. I hope you are enjoying all my sessions. If you like my class, please give me a thumbs up. You have to hit the bell icon so that you can get all the reviews or all the notifications for my classes. And you have to subscribe for any course on an academy using my referral code CHESHTA10. So good night all of you. I hope you have enjoyed my classes. We'll meet again tomorrow. Till then, bye-bye and take care.